Welcome to 2024, Fontana. January 23rd marked the first council meeting of the year. Before the meeting's official start, there was a closed session to discuss the cases regarding litigation. This agenda focused heavily on contract awards, construction and infrastructure projects, and grant funding. At 2 p.m., the meeting officially started with Fontana's Housing Development Manager presenting the achievements and highlights of 2023. Some of these include one emergency shelter facility and 14 units of interim housing to address homelessness, 191 seniors receiving recreation scholarships of a maximum of $500 to assist with registration fees for community service programs and activities, 4,892 individual contracts by providing outreach, education, and resources to assist with the homeless population, receiving the Lead Hazard Reduction Grant of $4 million to protect the health of children and vulnerable populations living in older housing units containing lead-based paint, and the Healthy Home Supplemental Grant of $400,000, which will be used toward homes undergoing lead hazard control work. Looking forward to 2024, the Housing Department will continue to increase the volume of affordable housing units, identify and apply for grant opportunities to increase funding, which will support the expansion of programs and services, and launch the program addressing lead hazards to families with children. Then, Fontana's Community Services Department was awarded a Southern California Municipal Athletic Federation Gold Shield Award for their outstanding contribution to the organization. SCMAF is a nonprofit that provides year-round youth and adult athletic competitions and aims to support recreation-based programming of its members. Stan, also from CSD, was recognized as a Golden Shield Award winner. Stan worked in collaboration with SCMAF and other local municipalities to organize and host a training workshop, Surf and Turf, for other recreation professionals focusing on sports and aquatic programming. Congratulations to Stan and CSD for this achievement. A consent calendar groups routine items together so they can be passed at the same time. To start, there was a second reading of ordinance number in 1939 regarding targeted picketing. Nadage Corporation was awarded the contract for the Sierra Lakes Pavement Rehabilitation Project for $1,647,818. This project will replace asphalt and concrete and make ADA upgrades to curb ramps so that it is more easily accessible. During 2023, there was a project to improve sidewalks for pedestrians traveling to and from the Kathy Binks Elementary School. In January 2024, there was a final acceptance of the project, which officially marks the work as complete and satisfactory. The final construction came out to $321,737.09. Fontana's city manager was authorized to execute an easement deed with the San Bernardino Flood Control District for the Nara Hills community. This would allow the city of Fontana to operate and maintain the sewer improvements constructed by the developer, which are located within the San Bernardino County Flood Control's jurisdiction. A portion of the city-owned property on Oleander Avenue was declared as an exempt surplus land. Do you know about Fire Station 81? Near completion and located on Casa Grande Avenue, the new location can better serve the north side of the city as the community grows. During this council meeting, there was a lease agreement for the station with the Fontana Fire Protection District. WECA Inc. was awarded a contract for infrastructure improvements for the Court Place Housing Development for $4,863,524. The project includes the installation of a storm drain system, sanitary sewer system, restoration of existing improvements, and more. The City of Fontana has been awarded $37,919 from the Office of Homeland Security as part of the Fiscal Year 2022 Homeland Security Grant Program. The Fontana Police Department plans to use these funds to purchase various equipment such as canopy tents, computer hardware, and cameras. From July 2023 to December 2023, the Fontana Police Department received various donations from members of the community. Donations include meals, gift cards, tickets to services and entertainment, monetary donations to charity, and more. The complete list of donations can be found on fontana.legistar.com. Thank you to all the donors for your generosity. Approval to purchase Block Group camera equipment and software will be used to help improve public safety throughout various locations within the city. Then, it was the monthly police department update. Some noteworthy events are the area commander meetings taking place and the seizure of illegal firearms and narcotics. Fontana is one of the recipients of the 2023 Edward Byrne Memorial Justice Assistance Grant, along with several other cities within the San Bernardino County. The county served as the grant administrator on behalf of all the cities within its jurisdiction. While Fontana is eligible to receive $58,201, the county will retain a 5% administration fee of $2,910. Therefore, Fontana will receive $55,291, which the police department will use to purchase radio equipment. Custom Craft Flooring will be contracted for $214,700 to provide emergency flooring repair at the Fontana Senior Center. Some areas consist of lifting due to moisture that can be a hazard for those at the center. Once the existing flooring is removed and dried, new flooring will be installed throughout the first floor. An agreement with SA Golden Investments was approved for a city-owned property that was deemed surplus in 2023. Usually, when a municipality declares property as a surplus, affordable housing providers are offered the land before selling or leasing to anyone else. In this case, no qualified affordable housing providers presented a proposal during the state-mandated notice period. A contract with Servium by Wright LLP was approved to serve as a city prosecutor. Code Compliance has used their services in previous years and wishes to continue their professional relationship. In case you didn't know, the City of Fontana was awarded a $3 million grant in 2023 from Assembly Majority Leader Emeritus Eloise Gomez Reyes towards the downtown revitalization efforts. Funds will be used for the construction and planning of projects such as the expansion of the Fontana Art Museum, mural restoration, and 9/11 Memorial. The next step of grant funding is to go through appropriation, which is receiving an official permission to use the funds achieved through the January 23rd council meeting. That concludes the consent calendar. You can find more details on these items at fontana.legistar.com. Moving on to public hearing items, which provide an opportunity for community input, these items were included. Proposed liens for sewer, rubbish, and weed abatement accounts that are delinquent. Agreements with Fontana Responsible and Compliant Retail, LLC, regarding the retail cannabis business, and an abatement for the West End specific plan to include escape rooms. As the meeting concluded, the City Council went over new business. On January 23, 2024, Mayor Pro Tem Garcia was chosen for another one-year term. Part of the responsibilities as Mayor Pro Tem is to preside over council meetings when the elected mayor is unavailable. Congratulations to Mayor Pro Tem Garcia! Full details of the January 23, 2024 City Council meeting can be found at fontana.legistar.com. Community members of the City of Fontana are invited to attend City Council meetings every second and fourth Tuesday of the month, located at the Grover W. Taylor Council Chambers at 8353 Sierra Avenue, Fontana, California, 92335, beginning at 2 p.m.